The Jerry Sandusky trial moving along faster than even our legal experts expected. Some major developments today.
Well, let's get right to them. The judge says the jury could have the case by Thursday. The defense just started calling its witnesses. The first ones were coaches who say they too showered with young boys. And then there's this.
I didn't go around seeking out every young person for sexual needs that I've helped.
Today, NBC played a never-before-heard part of the Bob Costas interview with Sandusky. The prosecution ended its case with a mother on the stand in tears. The mother of victim 9 testified her son's underwear often went missing. Channel 11's Courtney Brennan has our live coverage with a breakdown on all of the testimony that she's hearing. Courtney?
Gordon, as you said, Jerry Sandusky asked his friends to testify today on his behalf, and we heard from them. They were former football coaches. They were former co-workers, but their testimony wasn't very compelling, and that is fueling speculation that Jerry Sandusky might have to take the stand in his own defense. Now, two prominent former Penn State football coaches told the jury about their relationships with Sandusky. Both Dick Anderson and Booker Brooks said Sandusky has a wonderful reputation in the community. Their testimony then got more personal and focused solely on Sandusky's habit of taking showers with young boys. Both men admitted that they thought nothing of that. Brooks went on to say that he takes his granddaughter to the YMCA and showers with her. Anderson then took it a step further when he said he showered with young boys and showers with young boys all the time at the YMCA. We spoke with one of the alleged victim's attorneys after that testimony.
There was this odd and bizarre attempt to convince the jury somehow that showering is culturally and accepted in this world. I don't see how that takes anyone very far.
As Gordon and Peggy mentioned, this trial is moving at record speeds. The judge told the jury today that they will hear closing arguments on Thursday and then could start deliberating as early as Thursday afternoon. Reporting live in Bellefonte this evening, I'm Courtney Brennan, Channel 11 News.
The attorneys representing victim 5 have been subpoenaed to testify for the defense. We're going to be there when the first witness is called to the stand tomorrow.